So this next piece of music is a four-movement suite that we're going to play continuously throughout. And Piazzolla wrote it originally for flute and guitar to tell the story or the history of the tango, from its origins in the houses of ill repute in Buenos Aires in the late 1800s, moving ahead by 30-year increments approximately, to when it started to be music not just to be danced to, but music that people like to listen to, and it became more romantic and more musical. And so that's 1930, where it was being played in the cafes. And then moving to 1960, it started to become more hip and more chic and more jazz influenced. And that's the nightclub, 1960. And then he moves forward to when he wrote the piece in 1985 and calls it the Concert of Today. And it's even infused with elements from Bartok and Stravinsky and very avant-garde composers. I should also mention that it originated, tango originated with the flute and the guitar, which is why those are the instruments that Piazzolla chose to write this suite for. But there's going to be some other surprises.
Thank you.
music on this program is from South America. We're just leaving Argentina now. We're going to Brazil. There's a Canadian connection with this next selection. A little program change. We are only going to play one of the Machado pieces. We're going to play a piece called Choro Sem Lágrimas. Celso Machado grew up and was trained in Brazil, became a world-famous guitarist, composer of guitar music especially, and he ended up settling in Canada and has lived here on the West Coast for many decades now. This piece, Choro, the root of that word is from street musicians, and it means a cry. And Sem Lágrimas means without tears. So this piece is a cry without tears. Samba and choro, the history of this music in Brazil. But in the late 1950s, there were songwriters that were beginning to take samba and slow it down and make it a little bit more gentle and a little bit more relaxed, and to combine it with the influences of cool jazz from America. And so what we ended up was something known as bossa nova. And the most important composer of bossa nova was Antonio Carlos Jobim. And so this next piece, I've put together two of his very famous pieces, Sodanzo Samba, which means I only dance the samba, and the famous Girl from Ipanema. We'll hear the samba theme first on the flute, then the Ipanema theme on the tenor saxophone, Alistan Getz, and then we hear the two themes dancing together. It's another